Welcome to the Little Drops of Wonderful podcast. My name is Ali. I am coming to you from Kent in the UK. And this is my podcast to talk about crochet, knitting, yarn making and all the good stuff. As usual, I am in my kitchen. I've changed my setup slightly because we've got some funny light today. It's very springy and the sun has been out for most of the morning, but it's kind of going in and out behind the clouds. So I've got a big window there. So the light's probably going to go up and down from that view. But what can you do? Welcome. I'm rambling already. Welcome to my podcast and thank you for coming back if you've been around for a little while. And also welcome to new viewers who have been popping up over the last few weeks. It's lovely to have you here. I usually pretend to have some kind of structure to podcasts, and I do talk about works in progress, finished objects, future plans, stuff incoming in the post, and that kind of thing. Oh, and today, a giveaway. Two giveaways, yes. Maybe even three, but two for today. Although I'm not quite sure how they're going to work. But yeah, I've got a lot to show you. So actually what I'm going to do, I've decided, is split everything into two episodes. So I'm going to do one today and one next week. So for the next couple of weeks, we'll do like a weekly podcast. And I've made some notes this week, and I've actually even got them in a Word document on my computer here. So I'm very organised, and I actually haven't looked at them once while I've been talking to you. So already that's gone out the window. So how you been? I was hoping to podcast earlier this week. Today's Thursday, so it probably won't be uploaded until tomorrow, Friday. I would normally podcast on Tuesday, but I had to work this week on Tuesday. I had to swap my days round, and that kind of put everything out of sync a little bit for the rest of the week. It's also been quite busy. We've had what's been going on. We heard. Sorry if I keep shaking this. I'll try to not keep banging the table. We got the results. Not the results. We found out what secondary school my eldest daughter's going to, and she got her first choice, so that's good. And it's been steadily getting more spring-like. I think today is the first day it's got properly warm. So I've just literally made myself a cup of skinny vanilla herbal tea, which Lorraine Pugh sent me from Lorraine Pugh Designs. It's still a bit hot, but it's very tasty. I thought I'd better have a herbal tea because it took me so long to get all set up for making the podcast that I drank an entire cup of tea. So I've had two already this morning, and it's not even 10 o'clock. So I thought I'd better just ease up a little bit on the caffeine. Right, waffle, waffle, waffle. Let's get started. So I think we should start with finished objects. I have one official finished object. I will just consult my notes. Yeah, I have one official finished object and one modified finished object from a previous episode. I think I talked about it last time, but let's start with my actual finished object, which is my Bella's Mittens, which is I've been making mittens because I'm taking part in the Basket of Mittens Cow, which is a year-long cow hosted by Tiffany of the Woolen Homestead and Carrie of Serenity Farms. Tiffany has a podcast. It's called the Woolen Homestead. And Carrie does not have a podcast, but she has a website, which is Serenity Farms, if you Google it. Serenity Farms, I'll put the link up on the screen. And she's also on Ravelry as Granny Sheep. Anyway, I'm joining in with their Basket of Mittens Cow, which works very much like the Box of Socks Cow, except it's mittens and it's a basket. So these are my January ones, so I'm a little bit behind in finishing. My February ones are a half-finished object, and I won't talk about those again this week. But these are my finished Yes, mittens. And they're also my very first cable project. So I'm really, really pleased. They're made with chunky yarn. And I actually had this left over because I severely over-ordered when I made the monster that I made for my sister's birthday in January. I over-ordered this mustard yarn by about 4 balls. So I've made an entire giant monster, a pair of mittens, and I still have, I think, 2.5 balls left, or 3.5. So I think I'll definitely be making more of these to give away as presents, because they're a relatively quick knit because they're chunky. They're really effective. They're really, really warm and cozy. The pattern is so easy to follow, and it's free. It's a free pattern on Ravelry. I used 5mm circular needles and knit the magic loop. But I went a couple of weeks ago with my mum. There's a new knit and natter group started up in the local library in her village. And I went along with her and I took my mittens to work on. And halfway through, my needles broke. My Knit Pro, I can't remember what they were, Knit Pro Novas, I think they were, size 5, 80 centimetre cord, and they broke. So I had to put them to one side. Luckily, I had another project with me. I had some socks as well, so I wasn't just sitting there eating cake. Not that that would have been a bad thing, just sitting there eating cake, but it's nice to have knitting to do at a knit and natter. So I put these to one side, and then when I got home, I emailed Knit Pro, and I said, my needles broke, what should I do? And they said they have a policy where you contact the seller. So I buy all my needles on eBay, usually from a seller called Woolstack Turval, I think is the seller. I think that's who it was. And yeah, no, it was. That's the name. I'll put it up here. Yes, so I contacted them and they very helpfully, I didn't even realise that they'd seen my message, but the next day, so I emailed them when I got back from the knit and natter, and the next day, replacement needles arrived. I didn't even realise that they'd seen, I'd almost forgotten I'd sent the message to them. So they had just sent it out straight away. So I was really, really pleased with the customer service, and I will definitely be ordering all my needles from them in future. Or make the effort, you know, to check them first. So all finished into my basket, which I don't have with me, but I do have a basket for these. My February ones are the ladylike lace gloves, which I spoke about last week. I've finished one of them. They're kind of an old whip, and I've finally finished the first mitten, where they're kind of like wristies, and I need to get up the motivation to do the second one, because it's black yarn and it's quite a complicated pattern, but I'm determined. Okay, so my next finished object was a finished object last time, and that is my festive jester shawl, which is a pattern by Lorraine Pugh Designs. It's a lovely pattern, and I haven't got the picture of hers, but her version, which if I can get it I will up here, was a lovely deep sort of reds and really kind of wintry autumnal colours, both seasons in one, wintry and autumnal. And I had this yarn left over from another project, and it was the right weight, so I used this. But I knit quite tight. I probably didn't select the right hook to make allowances for that fact. And it's produced a wool that's not produced a fabric that's not particularly. It's not stiff, but it's not as drapey as I would like. And it came up too small because I knit it too tight. This is the construction, and it has beads that run, and there's a specific way that she describes in the pattern to attach the beads all the way down the sides, which makes it really fun to do. Is that coming out? Where am I? Sorry if I'm just waving it and you can't see anything. So really liked it, but then when I'd finished it, it had stopped short at about there. So which meant when I put it around my neck, it kind of stopped, like the edges were here, and it didn't feel right. So what I did was I just slip stitched in here, and then I chained 30, and then I worked my way back into the chain all the way back to the end, just with single crochet in American terms, which is double crochet in UK terms. And then I fastened it off, and then I made a little pom-pom, because you can fix everything with pom-poms, can't you? And I made another little pom-pom for this end. So I really, really used up all the yarn. I don't know how much yarn I used, because as well as my needles breaking, my scales, my kitchen scales have broken. So I can't weigh anything at the moment. And I can't find, well, they're not broken, they've run out of battery, and I can't find the right battery anyway. So now, instead of stopping all the way out here and looking a bit weird, it goes all the way down. Sorry if I keep wobbling. So you can see, oh, that's unfolded. Sorry, I'm very immature. We'll do it like that. There you go. So now I've got pom-poms. I'm so excited, and it sits just so nicely. Like, I wish it was winter again. I mean, I always wish it was winter, but I wish it was winter again, because this is going to be, I mean, nothing's getting through here, because it sits like a polar neck around your neck. Oh, so pleased with this. And I'm going to make, if I make more, I'm just going to put pom-poms on it. Just, yeah, pom-poms. Pom-poms are the answer. So, I'm so hot. Right, so that is my second finished object that was already finished that I crepted. So, shall we move on to works in progress? I'm just going to have a sip of my tea. My mug, by the way, was a gift from my friend Claire a few years ago. It used to be my desk mug at work. Anyway, that tea's delicious, Elaine. It's a clipper tea. Really, really nice. You know how some herbal teas are really wishy-washy? That's really tasty. Right. Works in progress. Now, I'm not going to show you all of them, because I'm going to save some for next time. But I'm going to show you my... Oh, this is so exciting. I'm going to show you something I'm so excited about, which I've had to stop because of my scales problem, because I need to weigh the yarn before I can work out where to stop. So if you look back on my channel, one of my little extra videos that I did was about my first foray into dyeing yarn. And I dyed two skeins of yarn. Well, it was one skein, and I divided it into two so that I could try two different techniques. I wanted to do one in a pot on the stovetop, and I wanted to do one hand painted, where you lay it out and you apply the dye to the damp yarn. The result was two 50 gram skeins that were very, very different, and I decided I was going to knit one of them up, because I really wanted to see how it knit up, how it works. So from the process of placing the dye to seeing it knit up and how that works. So I balled up my the yarn that I dyed on the stovetop, which is a very kind of pastely delicate shades. And I did all this with Kool-Aid, by the way. So these are all colours made using the Kool-Aid drink. And if I show you, I'll just grab the other skein that I did, in case that you're new and you haven't seen it. Oh, sorry, I'm trying not to wobble the table too much. I apologise if I am. So this is the other skein that I did, and this was the hand painted one, and I used all the same colours, so you can see the difference. So this is a lot more vibrant. I used a lot more dye and a slightly different technique, and then using the same colours, I got this one. So it's amazing. It's absolutely fascinating. I can't wait to do more. So I was I have 50 grams. And after I went to Ravelry a couple of weeks ago, I bought a sock set from Hand Dyed by Kate. And the weight of that yarn was, the main yarn was, or what was it? The main yarn was 50 grams, I think. And the contrasting yarn was 20. Or was it 60, 10? I'm sure it was 50 grams for the main yarn and 20 grams for the contrasting yarn for toes, heels and cuffs. Because I remember saying to her, oh, is that enough? And having a whole conversation about it. And she was saying, yeah, that's plenty, you know, for an average sort of size, 5-6 foot. Sorry, trying not to wobble you. So that got me thinking that I could actually get some socks out of the yarn that I dyed for the 50 grams. So, also by Hand Dyed by Kate, this was sent to me by, again, Lorraine. Lorraine, you're like sponsoring the podcast today with my tea and my mini while it's here. So she sent this to me a while ago. She sent me some minis, and this was left over from a shawl that she was making, and it's part of a gradient yarn called Moody Melon. So this is part of that gradient. And I thought, ooh, that would go nicely, wouldn't it? So that's going to be my contrast. And here is, building the suspense here while I try and flatten it, what I like to call my springtime socks. So this is my hand dyed yarn, and this is how it's knitting up. Very kind of light pastely springy colours, and I love how it goes with this Moody Melon. So I've done my heel. It's really hard to show you because this is on, I tend to knit on short circulars. There's the contrasting heel. Oh, I'm using, these are, I don't know what size these are. Let's measure them. Hang on. I've got a really very, very cheap and cheerful knitting gauge here. Let's see what size the needles are. It's the one that goes through easily, isn't it? If it gets stuck, then that's not it. So in that case, these are 2.5 short circulars. And I am using, again, which is my go-to pattern, which is the Sockmatician's Toe Up Socks pattern by Nathan Taylor, who is the Sockmatician here on YouTube and on Ravelry. It's a great pattern. There's another pattern actually that I bought, which was Mina Phillips pattern, the Knitting Expat. And she's released a pattern as well, which I would like to try. I think that is Toe Up. I do prefer Toe Up. And I just can't believe how well it's going. Look, let me show it to you. If you look at it with the Moody Melon and the springy hand dyed and my little toadstool, it's like springing a sock. Really pleased with that. And it's really fascinating to have dyed the yarn and know how I placed that dye onto the yarn, and then to see how it dyes up. And I'm really pleased that it's dyeing up quite evenly. I'm just, usually when you hold it up in front of the camera, that's when pooling is revealed, isn't it? I can't see anything too dramatic going on there. That's all right. These are 56 stitches, which I have found, I think that's about, I know the average is 60 stitches, I find that's too big. All my socks that I've knit have been around 60 stitches, and it's too big. Even on 2.5, even on 2.25 millimeter needles, even on 2.25 millimeter needles, it still comes up too big. So for these ones, I've gone to 56 stitches, and we'll see how that works out. These are for me. Actually, at the rate I'm going, because I've already knit myself two pairs of socks this year, and this is my third, and they're for me. So I could join in with the box of socks, Cal. But could I handle the pressure? I don't know. Anyway, so that is my own pair of hand-dyed... socks in the making. But I've had to stop because I've passed the heel, so now I'm just going to knit until it's time to swap the colours for the cuff. And I don't know when to stop because I need to weigh the yarn to make sure that I stop at the right point, that I've got enough left for the second sock, and also to have a bit left over for my next work in progress. Seamless link into the next project. And these are just living quite happily and quite comfortably in my teeny tiny little handbag knitting keeper, I suppose you could call it. It's just a tiny, simple little knitting pouch just for popping things in your handbag to stop them getting all tangled up. And that is by Pickle Lily. Yeah, Pickle Lily. I bought that at Festival. It's really handy. This goes into my bag just like when I'm taking the kids swimming or taking the kids to their trampolining or whatever it is they're doing that day. So my next project is my Crazy Memories blanket. So this is a, guess who it's a pattern by? Lorraine Beauty Designs. Sorry, Lorraine. Your ears must be burning. So, this is Lorraine's pattern. Lorraine is a crochet designer, for those of you who have not heard of her before today. And she designed a version of Crozy Memories blanket squares, which is like a crochet version of the Cozy Memories blanket squares that are knitted, but these are crocheted. So the idea is that you make up all these little squares, and the pattern is actually for a double knit DK weight, but I wanted to use it as a way to use up my scraps for knitting fingering weight projects. So I started making my squares, and I had about 12 of them, but it was the process of starting them that was, it's just how I am as a maker. That process of not being in quite into the rhythm of the square, and you have to do like something different in the first couple of rounds and having to start that every time, it was kind of putting me off coming back to it. And then I thought maybe I could just keep going. Maybe instead of making many, many little squares and crocheting them or sewing them together, I could make 4 or 6 big squares. So that's what I'm going to do. And already I feel more enthusiastic about it. So this is my first square. So I took one of my original squares, which was the blue, and then I started adding to it. So yeah, obviously it's still quite a small square, but I'm just going to keep going because the pattern, how it is, you can just keep doing the same thing. I do tend to lose count sometimes. I don't know how I lose count. I think maybe I just miss a stitch or something, or do something ridiculous and stupid. I'm going to have to work it out because I've noticed that I'm a little bit out. So I'm going to have to do some counting. But that's me. That's not the pattern. So yeah, so this is Hermione's Everyday Socks, Love Along Socks, Strictly Socks. That's where the yarn's all from. And the idea will be that all of these squares will be totally different because all the yarn will be coming from different projects. And I'm not going to pay attention really to how they sit together. Whatever I've got free next, it will go into whatever square I'm working on until I have enough to sew together to make a really good size blanket. So I'm really, really pleased with how that's coming out now. Yeah, and I've got a little collection, a little bag in here of leftovers. That I will be adding in. I don't know how well you can see that. So I've got plenty to keep me going. And I've got some more minis as well, which I have received, which I will talk about in a moment. So yeah, the Crozy Memories blanket. Oh, and I'm using my hook, I'm using a 3.5mm hook for this project with 4-ply yarn. And this is my hook. I don't know if you can quite see it. But it's a hook that I bought, I think it was from Strand Designs in Ireland, whose yarn I've bought quite a bit of. I'm sure it was from her. Yeah, and it's really lovely to work with. It's got like a Fimo moulded handle. It's got a little thing for your thumb. Really like that. So that is my other work in progress that I'm talking about today. I'm going to save the other one for later. So let's move on. Oh, this is going to be the biggest section. So actually, no, I was going to move on to stuff that I've got incoming. But before I do that, let's talk about giveaways. Shall we? Let me just put this away and have a mouthful of tea. Right. So, I never thought really, so doing this podcast was something I promised myself that I would be doing before the age of 40. We're now at episode 12. I'm 40 next month. Oh, I can't believe it's come round already. There was so much I wanted to sort of, you know, I had this list of things I must do before I'm 40. I've not done any of it. Well, I started a podcast. So that's good, and I'm really enjoying it. And actually, the podcast bit has, what's the right word, enriched my life much more than I could have ever anticipated. The people I've met through doing it online have shown me that the world is actually full of nice people. And sometimes it doesn't feel like that, does it? But it is, this little community that we're all in. I know people say that on podcasts all the time, this community that we're all in, this knitting and crochet and crafty community. But it is, it's true, it's amazing. It's just full of these wonderful women and men. And yeah. Rambling, sorry. Right, so giveaways. Speaking of wonderful people, I had two people contact me just to say, would you like a free copy of my pattern and also a free copy for a viewer of your podcast that you could give away? And I was like, yeah, yes, please. So I've had two patterns donated. One is from Barbara, lovely Barbara of Knitting I Love. She's got a podcast on YouTube and it's called Knitting I Love, which I will put I'll put up here. And she is so full of energy and she is so much fun. It's so different to any other podcast and it's just so full of energy and happiness. And you can't not feel, is that double negative? Anyway, you can't come away from watching her podcast without feeling happier than you were at the beginning. And she has donated her Go Slow hat pattern. So you can have a chance to win that. And it is a ribbed pattern in a worsted weight yarn. And I'll put a picture up here. It is an absolutely beautiful hat and you can wear it in a number of ways. In fact, she's made a little video. If you go and have a look at her channel, she's made a little video about it and about how you can wear it and what you need to make it and other information. So that's worth watching. I'm definitely going to be making it and I've got some yarn in mind for it. So we've got a copy of that. And oh, what else did I want to say about that hat pattern? Oh yeah, that's it. I knit continental, so I hold the yarn in my left hand. So I haven't actually found a comfortable way to that I find that I can purl quickly. I mean, I can do it. It's easier with chunky yarn. But yeah, so things like when I'm doing a heel on a sock or anything that involves purling, I don't have a quick and natural way really to do it. But this pattern, she knits continental as well. And this pattern, she was saying, includes a method of doing the purl stitch for continental stitches. You don't need to use that method. You can use whatever method you like, but it does include that. So I will definitely be knitting that because I could do with some assistance in that department. And the other pattern that I'm really excited about is the Higa. I'm saying that wrong, aren't I? Higa. You know, the buzzword at the moment, the Danish, I read it as Hig, but it's not Hig, it's Higa. I'm sure it's Higa. Shawl, the Higa shawl by Lily of Nordic Stitches. So she has given us a pattern to for a giveaway. And I thought with that, oh, let me just talk about it for a moment. It's a lovely shawl. I think it's in two colours. Again, I will put a picture up here. And I think it is, oh, I can't remember what weight the shawl is. Okay, what weight the yarn is. I'll put that up here as well. But it's really pretty. And I think she's going to do a cowl as well. I think she said it was going to start at the beginning of May and run through till June for that shawl, which is great for me because I've got so many projects that I need to get done that something to look forward to on the 1st of May would be perfect. The pattern is being released on the 17th of March, which is Lily's birthday. So she's releasing it to coincide with that. And what I thought I would do for this one is I have got a copy of The Year of Living Danishly. It's a book that I read some time ago and then I received another copy. So I've got a brand new copy of that and that kind of ties in with the whole Higa thing. So I thought maybe what we could do with that one is the pattern will come directly from Lily to whoever wins it. But I will also put together a little Higa package which will include the book and just a couple of little, you know, just a very small parcel of some cozy items to help you feel cozy and get Higa. I think that's the right way to use it in a sentence. So I'm going to need a way to, how do we do a giveaway? I don't have a Ravelry page. Maybe I need to set, do I need to set up a Ravelry page? I've never set up a Ravelry page because I didn't want to, I don't really use Ravelry in that way. I use it for logging projects and keeping up with other people. I didn't want to create a group and then it just be me sitting there on my own in the group with tumbleweed flying past, you know, the wind howling through an empty group. But that seems like the best way to gather responses for a giveaway. So let's do that. When I finish recording this, I will set up a Ravelry group. I will call it Little Drops of Wonderful. I will create a Ravelry group. And in that group, I will create two threads. One for the giveaway for the Higa shawl pattern and the little parcel from me. And one for the Go Slow hat pattern from Knitting I Love. And I will put a prompt for each of those threads. And I think what I will say is, for the Go Slow hat giveaway, if you can go to the giveaway thread and tell me your favourite thing to do to relax. No, tell me your most relaxing thing to knit or crochet. What is the pattern that you always do, or the most relaxing pattern you've ever made that was just so much fun and wasn't boring and didn't require so much brain power that it sent you mad? So what is your most relaxing thing to make? I will put that a lot more succinctly and in a way that makes more sense in the thread. And then for the Higa giveaway, let's say if you could go into that thread and tell me your favourite way to get Higa. What's your favourite way to be cosy? And I think for both as well, I'll set up an introduction thread, and for both of those giveaways, make sure you introduce yourself in the thread as well. There you go. Then I'll have three threads and people will be introducing themselves, so you all know who each other is, and I won't feel lonely sitting in a Ravelry group on my own. Billy no mates. Does that make sense? Head over to the Ravelry group, which doesn't exist at the time of speaking, but will exist by the time you see this. and have a look and all will be explained. God. Stop talking. So, yay, first giveaway. Thank you, Lily, and thank you, Barbara. That was incredibly generous of you, and I can't wait to make those patterns. They both look right up my street, and yeah, they're lovely. Really looking forward to that. And Lily, I will definitely be joining in with your cow for the shawl. So, oh, and I will be doing another giveaway to coincide with my birthday, which is next month, my 40th birthday. But I will come up with what that's going to involve at a later date. So moving on to, let's talk about future plans before incoming. I feel like it's a bit all over the place today, but very quickly, all of my future plans are crochet. Because it is birthday season in our family. It is my husband's birthday. It is my eldest daughter's birthday. It's my mum's birthday. It's Mother's Day and all kinds of other things. And my birthday, but I'm not making myself anything. So I made at Christmas when I got a copy of this book, and my whole family selected the monsters that they would like. But the first one I'm going to be making, which is the most important one, is the one that my daughter, who will be 11, has selected. And I'll just show you the combination. This is a flip book. So you select the type of head, you select the type of body, and you select the type of arms. And she has chosen number 21, 19 and 18, which gives us this little guy. And she wants it in pink and purple. The yarn is on its way. It's going to be the same chunky yarn that I used for my sister's one, which is also the yarn that I used in my Bella's mittens. So I'm going to be making that. And Dan has also selected a monster, which I will try and get done in time for his birthday. I also want to make something from this book, because I'm going to talk about this next week, and I would like to make a start. This was given to me for free. This was from Meteor Books, and they saw on a previous podcast that I had been making and absolutely loving the things I was making out of the Zoomigurumi 5 book. And they saw that and contacted me and said, we've got a new book coming out, and it's called Zoomigurumi 6. So if we send it to you, would you review it on your podcast? So yes. And I would have said yes anyway, but when I went to have a look at the details for the book, there was a pattern. And as soon as I saw it, I was like, oh, hang on a minute. I better cover it up. Hang on. Can you see that? It's a sloth! It's a crochet sloth. It's a crochet sloth. Oh, the excitement when this book arrived. This is Cedric the Sloth by Irene Strange. It's all different designers throughout this book. My children, the moment this book arrived, stole it, ran upstairs with a packet of post-its, and my youngest one went through every pattern with post-it notes and wrote who she thought I should make them for. So every pattern in here, Daddy, Granny gets the owl. Everyone. See? Everyone gets a pig. Pigs for everyone. Yeah. Shawn the shark. That's my eldest. Daddy the dude. Maybe that's Dan's writing, actually. Who knows? Anyway, they've all been through this book and basically put their post-it notes on what they want. So I want to talk about this in more depth. That's not my review. That's just me going, oh my God, I've got a book and it's got a crochet sloth in it. Ah! So I will be talking about that next time, but I wanted to make a bit of a start on it because I can't really review something until I've made a proper start on it. So that will probably be next week. What's the other things? Oh, Mother's Day. I made my mum randomly. I had some leftover cotton yarn and I made my mum a dishcloth in red. This stuff. To match her kitchen. Her kitchen's white and it's got like red accessories. And I made her a dishcloth, and she's used it to death, basically. It started to fall apart. So I've got a load of this. I want to make her a load more dishcloths as a kind of little token Mother's Day present to go with the other bits. So I want to make that. It's all about birthdays and monsters. Oh, and what? Someone tagged me in something on Facebook, and I so want to do this. I don't know if you've heard about this, but there's this whole thing about crochet octopuses for babies, premature babies. So I'll just see if I can get it. So, premature babies on the neonatal intensive care unit are being given unique crocheted octopuses to remind them of being in their mum's womb. And apparently, this is actually proven to help them. So it says, after specialists show that snuggling the tentacles could lead to better breathing, higher levels of oxygen in the baby's blood and more regular heartbeats, the idea became a hit. I think it's originated in Denmark, and there's quite strict sort of rules about what they need to be made of and how they need to be crocheted. But you knit these octopuses, don't it? Oh, look, it's reflecting. You can just see my camera set up. But yeah, you knit these octopuses and you donate them to your local hospital. And our local hospital put a call out on Facebook saying, is there anyone who can crochet these octopuses? And about 100 people tagged me in this thing saying, oh, this looks up your street. So I feel I've got some. I'm pretty sure it might call for this type of cotton yarn. And I do have some in other colours. But I will go and check to make sure, obviously, that I'm doing it exactly the right way. Because this is a, I'm sure this is a worsted weight. But I will check. And if I've got the right stuff, I will do an octopus as well, or a few octopuses. I think the idea is they want to be able to donate an octopus to every preemie baby and give one to every preemie baby that goes home as well. Isn't that nice? Fine. So that's it for future plans. That's the making forecast. and I need to get on that. So everything else is basically on hold until I've got a house full of crocheted monsters. It's been a while since I've made a crochet shawl or anything. I think the last crochet shawl I made was the Victoria shawl by Cherry Heart. I loved doing that and it was so beautiful. I need to get back to my crochet garments. Right, I'm just looking at my notes. So, incoming. I have been a lucky girl because some wonderful people have sent me some wonderful things and I am very, very grateful. And trust me, you know, I savour these things when they come in. I open them, I marvel at what someone sent me, and then they put them all back in the package. And then I open them again over like the next week or so, like, and relive the opening of the parcel. First of all, I mentioned earlier that I was doing the basket of mittens cow. And they do a prize draw every month for someone in the group. So I won, well, it was supposed to be a skein of Carrie's Serenity Farms yarn. And she raises, is that the right word? Raises, Corridel, looks after, breeds, I don't know. Corridel sheep in Michigan, in the United States. And she has wool spun out of the sheep on her farm, and it's all natural, it's not dyed, so all of the yarn they produce is in the sheep's colour. And I won a skein and she said, what colour would you like? And I couldn't decide, so she sent me a sample of all of them. I have got all of this. I couldn't believe, I was like hopping about the house when this arrived. Getting all tearfully, happily tearful about it. And the kids are like looking at their mad mother, like crying about yarn, just like, yeah, that's our mother. Look at those colours. And I can't even tell you, they are so squidgy and they're kind of rustic feeling, but soft. Some of them are different to others, depending on the Right, so let me tell you about what's in them. So all of these yarns have got names as well that are inspired by Outlander. Now, I've not heard of Outlander, but on seeing these, we downloaded the first series and watched it and absolutely loved it. Yeah, really, really enjoyed that. I really enjoy it, especially because my parents are Scottish. So it was, you know, for me, it's really nice to watch something that's set in Scotland and to hear the accents and everything. Reminds me of family. So they've all got little quotes on them and they've all got different names. So this one is Murmuration, and this is a corridel and alpaca blend. And it's like a really, really, really dark chocolate brown. And then this one is, oh, you see, I love this. Some of them have got the names of the sheep. This is just pure corridel, and it's from their sheep called Castle and Ainsley. Look, there's the names of the sheep on there. Oh, the kids love that. When I said that this yarn came from sheep called Castle and Ainsley, oh, they thought that was just, they loved that. And then this one is, this is an alpaca and corridel blend. Oh, that last one was called Gravel Road at Dark. And this one is called Lord John Grey. This one is called A Breath of Snow and Ashes. How lovely is that? And this is from the sheep called Francie, Dawn and Hannah. And that's a pure corridel too. Look at the colour of that. Absolutely gorgeous. And this one too. Getting all excited again. Wise Woman. And this is corridel and alpaca. And this one is Dunbonnet. And it's from Leoch, Jesse and Ginger. It's just so cute. I just love it. And not only did she send me all of that and a lovely little handwritten note, but she sent me a little mini. I don't know if you saw, I spoke a few episodes ago about how much I loved Tiffany from the Woolen Homesteads hand-dyed yarns, but it's just so difficult to, at the moment, with everything being as they are, to order things for the United States. So she sent me a little mini from her own stash of Tiffany's Blueberry Crumble, which is the one that I said I love so much, and it is so pretty. Look at how pretty that is. So thank you, Kerry. Honestly, I was absolutely blown away by this package. At the moment I'm just happily, you know, looking at it and squidging it and going through that process. So thank you very much, Kerry, for that. I was so blown away by that parcel. Thank you. Okay, so next up, I've got so much to share with you and I'm really worried that this is going to be a really long episode. I'm going to show you two more things and then save one for next week. That's what I'm going to do. So I got my little French meadow. I've signed up for the monthly mini scheme club, which is really good value. If you're in the UK, go to Etsy, go to Little French Meadow, because it is such a lovely little surprise to get in the post every month. Oh, look, there's chocolate in here and I haven't eaten it. Oh, I'll have to have that. So this month was March, and the parcel was called The Luck of the Irish because it's St. Patrick's Day this month. And the two mini skeins are called Leprechaun and Pot of Gold. So this one will be Leprechaun, which is a beautiful emerald green. Coming up a bit more minty on the screen, but it's actually very, very deep emerald. And this one is a beautiful golden yellow. And it's got... I can never get things to focus. I'll see if I hide. A little leprechaun on it. And of course, gold. There was a couple more, but I think the girls snaffled them. But those are mine. I'm having those. So yeah, really, really pleased with that. It's such a good little club to like be in, because it's really good value. The schemes that they've sent and the little extras are so, I've been so pleased with them. So yeah, that's my little French meadow thing. That's coming in the post. And I also got the most amazing. I mean, I don't know. Look, this was the size of the box. And I'll show you what was fitted into this box. Now, this is from Himiko no Sakai on Instagram. Her name is Himiko. And quite a lot of episodes ago, I mentioned that I would really love to increase my collection of minis. Ta-da! She has sent me, how many has she sent? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15 minis. And she just contacted me and said, there's no point in it sitting around doing nothing, so you can have it. Do you see what I mean about people being incredible? And this just, when it arrived, I was having a really bad day. And I messaged her and I was just saying, it just reminds you that there are people who are just lovely. The world is full of these people. You just don't hear about them enough. So Himiko is one of them. And she sent me all of these minis. And not only did she send me all these minis, which I will show you, but she sent me a load of tea and some Belgian chocolate, because that's where she lives, and a little handwritten note as well. So thank you, Himiko. I was absolutely blown away by this little parcel. Look at all this tea. In fact, where I've been receiving parcels in the mail, I've bought myself a little box in which to keep my tea. And it opens, I just got it on Amazon, and I write on all of the tea who sent me the tea, so that when I come to think, oh, I'll have a herbal tea today, I know who sent it to me, and then I can, you know, I can think about that person and how nice they are to have sent me the tea. So these, I'm going to write Himiko's name on these in a minute. And they will go into my little tea box. And then I keep it all together. And also, speaking of being very organised, this is my basket, my little yellow basket that my husband bought me for a birthday a couple of years ago, just because I love yellow and he thought it was cute. And it's perfect for keeping minis in. So I've started to store all my minis in here. So I've been keeping my little French meadow ones together, because what I will eventually do is put a little tag on them so I can remember, and I can put all my minis in. So I will now show you. I've got this one, lovely little pink one. Oh, look at that, rainbow and blue. This is gorgeous. This is a really soft one. This looks like it might be hand spun, or is that just me? Anyway, it's gorgeous. I've got a purpley one. Oops. Look at that. That's gorgeous as well. This lovely sky blue. My Crozy Memories blanket is going to be the best Crozy Memories blanket in all the land. Oh, that's nice. That's got a nice little fuzz to it. Can you see that? A fuzz. I like it. Oh, that's a speckly one. I love speckles. Look at this one. I recognise this one. I don't know where from, but I recognise it. I'm wondering if that is from someone I follow on Instagram or I've favourited on Etsy, but I recognise that one. This is gorgeous. Look at that. That is a deep sort of purpley pink with like a brighter pink with it. This one, sparkly! That one. That one. That one's lovely, look at that. Yeah. So I am going to put all of these, will be joining my other minis, in my basket. So that's great. So I've gone from nothing to a lovely little collection of minis and chocolate and tea. So thank you very much, Kerry, and thank you very much, Himiko. And I do have a couple of other things that have come to me in the post, but I'm going to save that for next week because otherwise this episode is going to be over an hour long again. So I think that's it for today. Otherwise, this is going to be just far too long and I've been rambling enough as it is. I'm going to go and eat my gold coins and maybe even my Belgian chocolates. I think I've covered everything, and everything I haven't covered, I will cover next week when I do another podcast. So, oh, I went to Chatham Dockyard at the weekend, and it's a place where you can visit. It's a historic dockyard, and they used to make rope there. And it's also where they film quite a lot of the outside scenes for Call the Midwife. So I took some footage while I was there, because I know a lot of people do like Call the Midwife. So I took some footage to share at the end of the podcast. So I'm going to stick that on at the end now. I hope I haven't rambled on too much. I know what I'm like. I set out thinking it's just going to take half an hour, and then it's an hour again. I don't know how that happens. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please press like and give me a thumbs up, because that's always nice. And if you really liked it and you're not already subscribed, press subscribe, because then you can watch more next time, next week, when I talk about more things. And hopefully I'll have some monsters next week too. So thank you for joining me today, and have a lovely crafty week.